Good morning. Everybody here are thinking that English grammar is very tough, but once you understand the principles and the rules, it's going to be very easy. Today I thought of taking about tenses, which is a big tension for everybody. And one thing you should understand, children, tenses is a very important topic in the field of grammar. It is based on this tense only, you will have so many other branches. So grammar is a great ocean where we have to go dive inside and collect it. Then only when we collect also, just use the principles and rules, which will be very easy. Now today we are going to talk about tenses. So what is tense first? Tense shows the time of the action done. Here that means it describes when the verb is there. What is the condition of the verb? The timing of the verb. So verb is nothing but an action word. So tenses show the time of the action done means it describes about the timing of the verb. Here there are three major tenses. Hope you understood what is the tense. Now tenses means it is time. One short thing you should keep in mind, because we are going to divide them into three major divisions. One is present tense, past tense, present tense and future tense. See, it is not a 1 hour or 1 year or like that timing. Even a fraction of a second which is already finished, that falls into past tense, which is in the present, we take it as present. When we say talk about the next minute, then it will be future tense. Don't think next means it may be tomorrow or next week or next month. No, next minute itself is future only. Now see here, there are three major tenses and 9 subdivisions. So when you ask in class, most of the children, what they understand is we have only 3 tenses. Yes, of course, we have 3 tenses only, but they are major. After that, you have so many subdivisions. So 9 subdivisions are there under the 3. Under the 3, after the 3, you have 3 for each. And that makes 12 tenses. So there are 3 major tenses and 9 subdivisions. Totally, there are 12 tenses. So at the beginning, we call them simple past, simple present and simple future. Now we should understand what is past tense. Past tense means that has already gone. Even half a second which is already over will be falling into past tense. Now the simple past. So we will take a word. For example, you take work. Now when you take work, what will be the past form of the work? ED we have to add. Worked, past continuous, was working. Was we are giving. So was working. So here again you have to understand that we have to add auxiliary verbs. What are auxiliary verbs? Auxiliary verbs are nothing but helping verbs that stand substantial, which helps the subject to connect with the verb. So he is working. I was playing. So that is, was, all that comes under auxiliary verbs. If you want me to put in simple English, I'm telling you auxiliary verbs are connective verbs and they are helping verbs. In very simple English, you have to put means it is helping verb. Now, simple past, I told you, past continuous was plus ing. I'll be giving the next table or column for that. And even we have to go for first person, second person and third person and how it has to be used. So, I'll give you step by step. If you follow, you will understand tenses. Now, past continuous. Past perfect means we will put the thing had. So we have to use the auxiliary had and had worked. So that falls as past perfect. Then past perfect continuous means along with that verb you have to add being. B-E-I-N-G and ing form of the verb. When I put that table or column, I'll explain that. Next will be simple present. That is now work. Present continuous working. Present perfect has been working. Present perfect continuous has been working. Like that we will give been. B-E-E-N is added along with the auxiliary verb. When you go to future tense, the next minute I told you is future. So simple future tense, future continuous. Here for future tense there is a unique quality where you are supposed to add the modals. What are modals? There again they are a different group of auxiliary words. So they are also auxiliary words, but they fall in a different category called modals. So these modals will be used only for simple future tense. like how will and shall in the models we are taking, not may and might is excluded, but sometimes it may come. But here usually we take the models will and shall. So this will and shall will go along with the verb to give you a simple future tense, plus ing form, and the modal will give future continuous, and future perfect will be have and had. Okay, have will, here again the modal have is having two verbs in it. One is you will use for simple present, and if it is plural form you have to go for have. And one more thing is we use that for future tense. So we have future continuous, future perfect, and future perfect continuous. Here again, children, when I am talking about future perfect continuous, mostly we don't use them. Future perfect continuous, they are not in use, but only in occasional cases. If the verb needs, then only we are supposed to use future perfect continuous, or else in most of the grammar, this point is not highlighted. Is that clear? Hope you understood this part of the explanation. Next, I'll go to first person, second person, and third person explanation along with the table or column.